Hi guys, and welcome to the short SEO Dominator video tutorial. In this video tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how the software operates and how easy it is to find expired domains. Okay, so when you load up the software, we are going to see that there are several tabs, and now I'm going to explain each one of them. The search tab is where we'll be spending most of our time. We have the keywords panel, results panel, some status monitors, the drop down of which platform we are searching, start stop clear button, save results, save table, and delays between searches. I'll be showing examples for each one of them, just to show you the other tabs first. Keyword seeker is a place where you can find more keywords per seed or input keyword. If I input here a, let's say, bear, and click both Google and Bing or either one of those, I can click start, and the software will find me related keywords to the one that we imported. Right now we found up to, well, right now we are up to 800, and actually the software finished. We can stop the search while it is running. Like, I can stop it now, and stopped. I can clear everything, or I don't know. I can find other keywords. I can stop them mid-search. So now there's 228, but because we're getting them from two places, they're duplicates. So we need to click remove duplicates. We can save those. Or we can transfer them to the search. So all of those domains we found here are transferred now here to the keywords. The keywords panel is the panel that uses each keyword to find expired domains. The first way, as I showed you, is to find the keywords from here and transfer them here. We can clear them, we can type the keywords, we can import them, like we can have txt file on our computer, select it and import them and clear everything. The get backlinks feature is actually if we have URL, like any one of those, or whatever URL, we can put it here, and when we click start, the software will find the backlink URLs towards that domain. We can select how many URLs we want, and this is going from the top. So if we select 10, it will give us the 10 best URLs per the domain, or 100 or 200 best URLs that have backlinks towards the domain, and so on. The settings tab is where we can use the proxies. We can tap the proxies here. If we select the use proxies, that means that the software will use proxies for every search. We can import the proxies from a file. The format is the proxy and the port. So this is the proper format for the proxies. And basically that's it. If we select the file, the software will use the proxies. Of course, if the use proxies is selected. Then we have Moz API. We need to input our Moz credentials in these two places, so the software will be able to find the page authority, domain authority, and also use this get backlinks feature to get the backlinks towards the domain. Please note that the free Moz API is up to 2500 free searches, or if we select 1000 backlinks per URL, that means that we can do only two searches a month for 1000 backlinks. I mean, for the free, to use the free API limits. So that's why you should select it with less than maybe between 10 and 100. So the software is set up to get only the highest quality URLs first. So even if it's set up to 10 results, it will get you the best backlinks towards the domain. Okay, let's try that. Let's type in cup.kz, the one we have here, and click start. So the software is right now, we can put as many as we want URLs here to be checked, and they'll be checked one by one. And the software is telling us that now it's working on that domain, and this is the position the software is at the right moment. So if there are a couple of those, then it will be to position 2, and here it will show which domain is working. So when it says backlink getter finished, that means that we got the URLs where there are backlinks towards this domain. So there are only 2 backlinks to this domain. So well, the place where our software is saved for me is on my desktop. We'll have a file with the domain name, and here we can see the backlinks towards the domain. So here all the backlinks, actually there are 6 backlinks, but this tool finds all the backlinks, while the number here is only from those 6, only 2 of those are actually bringing any link juice, or they're useful. Okay, so we can stop the process if we have more URLs piled in. Let's get back to the settings. Select searching platform is from where the domains will be searching the domains. We can select Google or Bing. This is also for expired web 2.0 platforms and social media accounts. Timeout is closely related to your internet speed. So this means how many seconds the software will wait until it's able to get the domain. So if we put timeout on 1, that means the software will wait 1 second, and if the page is not loaded, I mean, if your pages are not loaded in 1 second, it will go on to the next keyword. So if we have slower connection, it's better idea to put the timeout on higher number. Threads are basically how many instances at once the software will be using. So if you have fast computer, you can put more threads. That means that the software will be operating that many processes at once. So if you put the highest number, that means that the software will use 5 keywords at once. So on your software there'll probably be a lot more threads to choose from, but even with 1 thread the software is fast enough. Okay, retries means if the software at the first try didn't get the domain, or didn't get information for the domain, it will check again and again, depending on how many retries you selected. If it's only 1, that means that the software will try only once and won't try for that keyword again. So this, I'm advising you to put this at least at 3. So the software will try 3 times before it gave up on that keyword and continue. Threads for expired properties checker means how many instances at once the software will be using while it will be checking if those domains are actually expired. And this is in which browser you'll be opening this check history links or the help links. So whatever browser you're using, you need to select it here. And the save settings button saves everything that's selected here. The filter settings are interesting. Pre-filtering setting that while the software is searching for your domains and before it shows you what it got, it will pre-filter in the preset filters here, so there is no need for you to see all those domains that you're not interested in. The help button have the contact us link tutorials where you will be having tutorial for each of these tabs, and our Facebook page that you should probably follow because we'll be having some great strategies on how to use the software. Well, there will be a lot of stuff for the client. So the button is so you can see better at the found results, and the down button to see the interface again. We have a search here that we can use to separate some of those domains. And okay, for all these other tabs we have explained everything except for search. So this is the place where we're going to be using the software the most. So let me show you how the software works. At first we can type in a keyword like lamp, I don't know what else, cup, news, robots. I input at random keywords. Obviously you'll be using keywords that suits your niche, and also it's smart idea to find related keywords here and refine your searches. So I'll be searching for expired domains from database. That means that we are going to be getting the domains from database that we know that were expired at some point, but the databases are not updated frequently, so some of those would be registered or some of those would be spammy, so the software will filter them out, and plus it will be using the filter settings that were set up here. Okay, so we selected the platform we want to search for. We inputted our keywords. We have four keywords here. Delay is, we can set delay between each search, between each keyword. So if we start getting some restrictions, this is a smart way to be able to get our results without using proxies. So we'll make the software slower. It's also advised, let's say we input delay of 3 and we use one thread, and that means that the software will search for one keyword at a time, and between keywords it will wait for some time also. But right now it's demo video and I'm going to put this on one. This is basically the slowest settings you can use, and I'm showing you even with the slowest settings how fast the software can operate. Okay, so when everything is set up and we have our most API keys and we selected all our settings, we can click start and let the software get our expired domains. Okay, right now it found 100 domains from these 4 keywords and is checking them for if they're expired, and also it's filtering them up if there are some, let's say quote unquote, bad domains or it filters them out, basically. It filters them out and it will leave you the domains you actually will want to use. Right now the software is checking number 23 from 100. That means that we need to wait this number to be 100, then we will know that the software finished checking these domains if they are expired. And right now from this 32, 22 of those are 23 are actually expired and most likely are able to be registered with whichever register you want to use. So this is all in real time, nothing is sped up. I'm not going to speed it up. I actually made it a lot slower, so someone with slower connection or slower PC will still be able to use the software. I might show you for the same keywords and results the faster version, but basically if I select 5 threads here or 10 threads or whatever number it will be possible, the software will be that many times faster than this. And also if I select the delay to 0, it obviously it will be faster. I didn't mention the delay is actually in seconds. So 0 seconds delay, 1 second delay, and so on. Okay, from 92 checked, we found 53 profiles, but they're still not filtered out. And now we'll be seeing the filter process, and I'm going to explain what is happening. Right now, the software is filtering up the results and goes 10 at a time. So that's why here it says 10. Result position 10, 20, then waits 10 seconds, 30, and so on until we reach the number here. This is because, the software is actually a lot faster than that, but the Moz API has its limits. So they allow up to 10 results to be checked and then wait 10 seconds and then 10 more. But still, this is not really an issue. And as you can see, in a couple of minutes we were able to find 53 expired domains. But of course, most of those would not bring any value to them. So we'll be lucky if we even find 5 of those. But that is still good, because with 10-15 minutes of work, we can find domain like this. With 24 page authority, 24 domain authority, and 10 links towards it. In order to check this to see the results we found more clearly, we can use the up button, and then we can sort the results by clicking these buttons. So this domain actually has a lot of links towards it, high page authority, high domain authority, and we can check its history. Please note, probably after this video, most of these domains that I'm showing you, some of you would have registered them, and this demo is just for now. Like, today is 12th of August, and 11 a.m. Eastern Standard, but plus one. I don't know how to pronounce that. So when we click the check history, the software navigated us to Wayback Machine, to our Chrome. If under settings, if under settings here it was selected Firefox, it would have been the browser here would have been Firefox. So on the Wayback Machine we can see separated dates where that domain was captured, and we can check what was on it. So when you select a date and we click on that, we can see, here it is, we can see what actually was on the domain. And if you like it, we should probably use it and register it in our favorite register. Okay, as we can see, the domain authority is pretty important, also the page authority. So this one also is showing really good stats, and on this search we actually found quite a lot of the domains that are really quality ones. This is getting the domains from places where no one saw them before. Okay, I'll be doing more searches shortly. Just let me show you a few more stuff. Because from all those 53 found results, we found 24 that are actually meeting our criteria from our filter settings and they're not spammy. You might want to check the ones that got filtered or got filtered out, and if you want to do that, you can just click the save results and the results would be saved on your desktop, and those would be these results, or you can copy them and paste them wherever you like. And if you click save table, the table would be saved as sorted here. So if I sort it like this, and it will save CSV Excel file, actually table, and you'll be able to use this table however you see it fit. So the results that I saved are here on the desktop. So as you can see, as it was sorted out, these are all domains that we found out. You can use this in other apps, or you can use it for your own search, or whatever you want to do with it. And these are all the domains even the ones that got filtered out. So let's get back to the software and let's see some other features. Tumblr is web 2.0 property that's quite popular. So if we try to find expired tumblers, we are doing the basic search exactly the same as we did it with expired domains, but now the software will be looking for expired Tumblr web 2.0 properties. So it found 60 from those 4 keywords, and now it's up to the number 40. Because we used a lot less keywords, there's high probability that the software won't find any. But I'll show you if we use small keywords, change the keywords. Okay, so right now the software didn't find any expired domain or expired subdomain from Tumblr, but of course we used a lot less keywords. So for this feature, I'll be actually using this keyword seeker, so we'll get more keywords. We'll be removing the duplicates, we'll transfer the results to search. Right now we have 128 keywords, but in order to make the software faster, and we'll skip the retries. Okay, we'll be checking them out now, and you'll get the chance to see it a little bit faster than previously. maybe 10 minutes skip, because it will be just boring video of waiting for the results to show up. So out of all our keywords, 128, that are not that much obviously, in about 10 or 15 minutes we found 19 profiles. So this is the great thing about the Expired Web 2.0 properties, and for especially Tumblr, that we are able to find some really great results. So as you can notice, there are a lot higher page authority, domain authority, or links than domains. And the good thing about this is also to register any of these properties is basically free, so you don't have to pay anything else to register this profile. It's also a good idea to save these properties, so if the platform don't allow you to register the property at the moment, they will probably in a couple of weeks. So it's a good idea to check them from time to time. So let's see. I can save the table. Okay. So from the table that saved on the PC, now on the PC in the, we can get, let's say, Jetpack app. Okay, we need this. We want to register this domain, and this is how we do it. We check if there is nothing there. Obviously, the software does it for us, but we wanna see it. Then we can add new Tumblr. We can add that URL and we can check if we can register that block. So for this one it says block URL is not available. That means that we cannot register this block at this block at this given time, but we can save it for later. So we go to the next one. That one is also not available. And here we go. We adjusted a Tumblr profile with 16 page authority, 9 domain authority, and 6 links towards it. So the next thing to do is just to populate the blog, to edit, add some features, add some content to it. Here, this is how it looks now. And we can use it however we see it fit. Many people actually don't believe that Expired Web 2.0 properties are valuable, but in order to prove them wrong, I created several, and I'm going to be showing you one from the blogger or blogspot that's owned by Google. I'm going to be using this property because on the platform you can see the stats and the traffic the offers got. Obviously some of these platforms will be easier to find, some of those this would be harder. It requires some trial and error, but overall it's not that hard, and if you spend one day on it or one working day, you can find enough domains so you can run your business or run one section of the business. And if it's used right, it can bring a lot of traffic and a lot of money back to your back to your accounts basically. So I previously opened up this one of my product review sites on Blogger, and I put there I think only 6 articles, or actually 5, because one is empty, and I got some comments. Earnings are from ads, and I haven't used any AdSense to it, but I used affiliate links. And although I don't know how much exactly I have earned from this, but because all my links from all my sites are pointed towards my account, or my accounts on JVZoo, on ClickBank, on Warrior Plus, on this particular subdomain, I got overall 27,000 or 20, almost 28,000 page views. Today got 30, yesterday 28. This month so far got around 300, and last month I got 1,200 something visits. So obviously some of those last month, or maybe even this month, ended up in sales. So that's the power of reusing these domains, expired subdomains that are free to register and require a little bit of work.